All right, guys, Nona November has begun. If for some reason you don't know what that is, allow me to explain. Nona November is an event that men can take part in the month of November. So for the entire month of November, that basically means you can't nut or ejaculate. This involves self-gratification, sex of any kind, anything that could make you ejaculate is a no-no. So, I have been participating in this month's events. It has only been 6 days, but we're reaching the end of the first week, and I was just gonna come on here and update you guys with what happens when a guy does this kind of stuff. First off, he becomes very productive. As you can see, I've organized my bed and stuff. My room is cleaner. My bathroom is clean. Everything is scrubbed. Because that's just what happens to you, man. You become productive. If you didn't know, I'm trying to practice cutting hair. I want to learn how to cut hair. So I've been doing that. I've been giving out haircuts and stuff. You become insanely productive when you do this. Because I don't know why. It's like all the time that you've used up to do that, you're no longer taking that time to do that. So now you're taking the time to do things that actually matter. Now, this does vary depending on who you are, okay? So, first off, I myself probably have an addiction. I mean, I do it a lot. I do it when I wake up. I do it throughout the day. I do it before bed. I've done it at work. Like, if you're at work and I'll go to the bathroom, get it done, and come back and act like it didn't just happen. I mean, I'm a sick freak. So if you're like me, then it kind of makes an impact on a lot of stuff. Now, if you also weren't aware, now I'm going to get a little science-y on you guys. Okay, I'm going to get science-y here. I'm going to break down some scientific knowledge for you. If you didn't know, jerking off mentally in your head gives you a lot of dopamine. The dopamine spike in your brain is almost, if not exactly, or even more, it's the dopamine in your head is that of taking drugs, like narcotics, the hard stuff. But the dopamine rush lasts longer than a cocaine high. So when you just quit cold turkey, it really does affect your brain and how you're thinking and how you're doing things. And it makes a big difference in your daily life. So if you're to stop doing it automatically, just out of nowhere, your brain, you can get sad, you can get angry, you can just start feeling like you're in a funk because your dopamine is off, your everything is a little bit off. So it can actually make a big difference in your day-to-day. Once it kind of blows over and you get used to kind of being in the groove, then I'm sure it'll be better, but maybe I'll check back in with you guys and let you know if that's the case. But for now, honestly, I would just say I've been really productive, and honestly, I feel like my nuts have gotten a little heavy, you know, the sperm is waiting to come out. But I've been keeping myself occupied, you know, I'm cutting hair. So, overall, first week, I would say overall, first week, I would rate it about a 6 out of 10, you know. It's a good week. A little bit of struggle here and there. Definitely some struggle yesterday, I would say. And it really does kind of throw you off. But you feel better not doing it. So I'll keep you guys updated, and I'm gonna go ahead and I'll keep you guys updated. Y'all, I think I'm about to fail No Nut November. I think it's over. I didn't even get to post the video of it starting before I failed. I can't sleep. It's 2 in the morning, I can't sleep. I'm stressed. I gotta de-stress. I can't do it, y'all. I can't do it. I'm sorry. Maybe next year. But I don't think I can make it. It's over. I'm sorry. It's official. Lost. Issa came. I fell to a moment of stress, a moment of weakness, and tell you what, I've never had, never been, I've never felt this much regret before. This amount of post nut clarity is insane. I'm pissed that I did it. I'm angry at myself. I don't know how I became this weak just because of a week of not doing it, you know. This really goes to show you guys, you shouldn't do it. And if you are, you at least shouldn't do it as much as you are. Try to lessen it as much as you can, because doing it as little as possible is probably the best way to do it. This was honestly just a little experiment to see how I would feel, and I was gonna document pretty much how I was feeling, but I didn't even make it that far. If you guys want me to try different stuff, like self-improvement stuff, to see how I feel, I'll share the honest results with you. So anything you have, cold showers, different routine for different things, let me know. I'll try it out, and I'll tell you guys how it goes. And for this one, I gotta say, not doing it is definitely the way to go, or doing it as little as possible is definitely the way to go. It just makes your mind sharper. You're more alert. You're less wishy-washy with your mood. Your mood doesn't go up and down. It stays pretty level, and you can control it a lot better when you're not doing this stuff because of that dopamine. It's a lot for you to take. And yeah, overall, after even a week, I would say it's just way better to stay away from it. So, yeah, you know, at least if you're going to, do it with some on your don't self-gratify. At least that way you work for it, you know. I don't know if that makes it any better, but I'm on the toilet and feeling regret. Yeah. Overall, it'll make you feel way better not to do it. So